Okay, so here we have our design of the classes we are going to build up on the top right-hand corner. And what I've done thus far is created a new Python file, and I called it inheritance.py. Now, based on our design, I'm going to go ahead and create a class called parent. There. The next thing to do is to initialize the variables of class parent, variables like last name and eye color. So to do that, I will define this class's init method or constructor. The first argument for this function we know is self, and the two instance variables for class parent we know are self.lastname and self.eyeColor. Now, the init function we know will receive a couple of values as arguments. So let me add them here. And we will use these two arguments to initialize our instance variables. Let me do that next. All right, you may notice that this piece of code is pretty similar to the code for class movie that we have written previously. By the way, one new thing I will do here is add a quick print statement inside the init method. It will print out parent constructor called. So this print statement will explicitly tell us each time the init method or the constructor of class parent is called. All right, to make sure that this code that we've written thus far actually works, let's go ahead and use this class. I will define an instance of class parent and call it Billy Cyrus, and we'll provide the two arguments that are necessary. The first of which is last name, and that happens to be Cyrus. And the next one is eye color, which is, let's say, blue. Now, a quick word of caution. Ordinarily, I would have kept these two things, the definition of the class parent and creating its instances, I would have kept them in separate Python files. But I've kept them both here in the same file for ease of demonstration. Okay, so to demonstrate that the instance actually works, I will print out its last name. Let me save and then run this file. And there's my output. It says the parent constructor was called, which seems appropriate because we created an instance called Billy Cyrus. And as soon as we did that, the class parent's init method got called, which had a print statement inside it. And then we printed out Billy Cyrus's last name, which it printed out correctly. Okay, so far so good. Now, you'll notice that there really isn't anything new that we have done here thus far. The new thing that we are going to try is called inheritance, which will happen when we create the class called child. Let's do that next.